Meet the Catholic Church, owners of a global child sex abuse scandal. In the past 50 years, around 30,000 people in 25 countries have reported abuse by Catholic priests. Church officials stand accused of failing to report cases to secular authorities. In a recent letter of apology to Irish Catholics, Pope Benedict XVI said fast-paced change and secularisation has led to moral decline, blaming modern society. But the Church's own paper trail shows it has known about and failed to deal with the problem for 2,000 years. The first recorded link between priests and paedophilia can be found in a manual for church officials from around AD 60 called Didache. Older than the New Testament, it made the rule clear, "Thou shalt not seduce young boys." In 309, the Church's Council of Elvira, which dealt with issues of clerical marriage and celibacy, said, "Those who sexually abuse boys may not commune, even when death approaches." In the 8th century, the Penitential of St. Bede, a renowned scholar and monk, argued that clerics sodomizing children should be punished. In 1051, St. Peter Damian wrote the Book of Gomorrah, which complained of rampant child abuse and attempts to hide it by church superiors. The book was addressed to Pope Leo IX, who reacted by punishing only the worst of serial sex abusers and arguing that abuse was a spiritual issue, not a criminal one. In 1140, a canon lawyer known as Gratian of Bologna called for pedophile priests to be put before secular courts. In 1568, Pope Pius V acknowledged the problem in the papal order, the Horrendum, calling for pedophile priests to be charged. In 1741, Pope Benedict XIV wrote the definitive church document on child sex abuse, the Sacramentum Penitentiae. He recommended the problem be dealt with internally. Historians of the church say that by the 17th century, a system of promoting and moving priests to avoid scandal had developed. In recent times, church laws passed in 1917 and 1962 called for cases to be handled in secret with no requirement to report offenders. In 2001, head of the Holy Office and future Pope, Cardinal Ratzinger, argued abuse allegations should be dealt with under the church's greatest level of secrecy, that of pontifical secret. This week, the Vatican pointed to guidelines created in 2003, but unfortunately not circulated, requiring offending priests to be reported to police. A small step forward, or further evidence of bureaucratic failure? The Catholic Church, owners of a so-called modern problem that goes back 2,000 years. Big on sin, big on guilt, not so big on confession.
Abuse is abuse. Whether that abuse is emotional, psychological, physical, or sexual.
Apologise unreservedly.
I unreservedly and unconditionally apologise.
I apologised. I said I was very sorry. I was shocked, saddened.
That I wasn't beaten for an hour, non-stop, by two of them. By two of them, non-stop, from head to toe, without a shred of cloth on my body. My God, Minnesota.
Context of, there have been lots of things throughout church history, and there have been lots of scandals. How do you rate this one?
Well, I've had this conversation with some colleagues over the last few days, and really consider the duration of this abuse and the nature of this abuse and the fact that it involved children. I do not think there's any episode to compare with it.
We talk about Holocaust. I was number 113. This is an Irish Holocaust. And may we never forget it. And we have to have something in O'Connell Street, the main city of this country. You know, it's international now, and I'm so happy about that.
You evil monsters, thousands of children abused by priests and nuns and institutions. Church and state knew but did nothing to stop torture. Victims furious, report fails to name the perverts.
This report, the Commission to Inquire into Child Abuse, it runs to 5 volumes, and it's a devastating account of the horrific litany of physical and sexual abuse in residential institutions the length and breadth of this country. It's actually almost unbearably too sad to read, and it paints a picture that is far worse than any of us could have imagined.
The extent of the depravity and the cruelty and the sadism that was exercised against defenceless, vulnerable children by people in whom we put our complete trust and total faith, people who have dedicated their lives to God and the Catholic Church, that they could behave this way, that it was covered up internally within the orders, not just then, but now.
Who can actually give me back my two brothers who died in care? You know, I will never see my two brothers. My siblings will never see the two brothers. We've actually lost three members out of eight of our family.
I'm left totally naked. They would kneel me down here when Hannah steps down on the fourth step. There was another brother, and he was the one who was administrating the punishment. They had this great big leather that was full of weight. He was whacking.
I got raped of a Saturday. Got a merciful beating after it, and then stopped. He came along the following morning and put Holy Communion in my mouth. You don't know what happened there.
Boy in our chain who was sexually abused every day except Christmas Day because the paedophile was drunk, got 20,000, and the redress board wanted to know, and excuse my vulgarity because I think it's shocking. What size was the paedophile's penis? And that is what is happening to our people.
The worst was seeing a young boy die. He was 12 years old. He was beaten by brothers on the landing and he fell over the banister. I overheard somebody say that my mother had died the night before. When I asked about it, I was ignored and dismissed. We were all lined up naked and slapped in the face a lot. We had to drink water from toilets and we were all washed in the same bath water. I was beaten and hospitalised by the head brother and not allowed to go to my father's funeral in case my bruises were seen. I was beaten until knocked out and my head split. My finger was placed in boiling water until all feelings were lost. When I told nuns about being molested by an ambulance driver, I was stripped and whipped to get the devil out of you. At 6, I was raped by a nun, and at 10, I was hit with a poker on the head by a nun. I can take any abuse, but the worst thing was having no one. I was told my parents were dead. I found out in my 50s they were alive. Night times were the worst. If you weren't taken out of bed and beaten, you were listening to it happening to someone else. I was beaten stark naked for wetting the bed. 2 or 3 different people would beat me. They liked beating kids naked.